the number one thing is we want people to stay off of the water. The Coast Guard, as well as other emergency responders, are going to be responding to hurricane preparations as well, trying to get our boats ready and prepared and out of the water. So we want to ensure that mariners are staying off of the water. That way we can properly prepare ourselves and we can have a quick response following the storm. Well, if you do unfortunately get caught out in a storm, the number one thing you want to do is make sure you have your life jacket on. The second thing you want to do is make sure you're monitoring the marine band radio as well as VHF channel 16 for any weather alerts or directions from the Coast Guard on what to do. The second thing you want to do is make sure if you have an emergency position indicating radio beacon to have that with you, as well as any sort of signaling devices such as flares that if you do get into trouble, the emergency responders can locate you.
Well, with the hurricane season, anytime we get a hurricane coming towards our area, for us, it's not so much the impact of the day of the hurricane is the problem, it's the days leading up and the days after the hurricane. Days leading up, we start seeing the storm surge, we start seeing swell, big waves, and anytime we get the bigger waves, we're going to see rip current activity increase. So people need to be very aware as the storm's coming towards us, as they're thinking about whether or not they're going to leave or what they're going to do. It's also not the time to start coming out to the beach and swim in a non-lifeguarded area, and it may not be the time to go in the water because we're going to see increased surf, increased waves, increased rip currents, a lot of water push that is going to make it just not typically normal for what we have down here.
First and foremost is to stay tuned to the weather and the weather updates. Understand what the storm is, if it's a developing storm. Understand what's being told as to where the path of that storm is potentially going to go. Don't second guess the storm. If you are asked for your particular area needs to be evacuated, don't second guess the evacuation. You need to put your family and yourself first. So we recommend a minimum of 3 days supplies of food and water, medicines for you and your family. And then just heed the warnings. If it says to evacuate, evacuate. You know, maybe in the last couple of storms you didn't have to, but the next storm you may wind up being in trouble if you don't. And if the storm is bad enough, it may create a problem where emergency services can't get to you in a quick time and you'll be on your own. And it's all created because you didn't move when move out when you were supposed to.
Yeah, the main thing is to try to prepare early because a lot of folks do prepare at the last minute. The lines get long. You start seeing runs on water, on generators, on food. Stores start running out trying to resupply because there's such a large population here. So you really do want to prepare early. A lot of things you already have laying around the house. There's a lot of great websites, like on the Virginia Emergency Management website. There's a ready.org where you can actually look at a list and get a pretty good list of just what you need. There's a lot of things you already have around the house. So if you just kind of take an assessment of what you have already around the house and try to kind of gather things together and then maybe grab a few of those things that you don't already have. One of the things to remember too, when you're talking about a hurricane, you know, sometimes it's not the survivability factor. Sometimes it's just also a comfort factor. I mean, are you willing to be without, you know, services, utilities for a week or more?